Hello everyone, this is Chromý and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this presentation, we will discuss the main processes that are typically identified in the research on language production from a psycholinguistic point of view. We will focus primarily on spoken language production. On this slide, we can see a classic model of language production, which was introduced by Willem Lehfeldt in the late 1980s. This model has been highly influential in the research on language production. Nowadays, other models would be probably preferred by various researchers, but we may discuss Lehfeldt's model here because it is intuitive and identifies various production components nicely. The main components are the conceptualizer, the formulator, and the articulator. The main function of the conceptualizer is to generate the so-called preverbal message. This is done with the use of the various external information, such as speaker's world knowledge, the situation awareness, and also the model of the present discourse. The formulator takes the preverbal message and its output is a phonetic plan for the utterance. On the way, the message is grammatically and phonologically encoded with the help of the mental lexicon. The articulator then generates the overt speech. Lehfeldt stresses out also the role of comprehension system, which is fed by both the phonetic plan and the overt speech, and which then informs back the conceptualizer through the parsed speech. Importantly, this model is serial and modular, which means that the components are separated and there is no interaction between them. The information thus flows unidirectionally. Other models, such as the famous model by Gary Dell, are different in this sense, and they stress out interactivity. One of the first sources of evidence for the process of spoken language production came from speech errors. Key study in this sense was Victoria Fromkin's paper The Non-Anomalous Nature of Anomalous Utterances. Based on a corpus of speech errors she collected, she argued that the speech errors are not random and there is a certain systematicity in what errors we make and what not. In other words, there are many logically possible errors which never happen. She offered a typology of speech errors based on various characteristics. Importantly, the speech errors are interpreted as evidence for individual production processes. A speech error is thus a reflection of a failure in a specific production subprocess. On this slide, we distinguish three main categories of speech errors. The first type are sound errors. These may be quite diverse and Fromkin distinguishes many subtypes. For example, they may rest in the deletion of certain sounds, such as in saying in a split second instead of in a split second. Another type of sound errors are consonant reversals, such as brittle island in litany instead of little island in Brittany, or Czech čáva a čaj instead of káva a čaj, which means coffee and tea. Other sound errors may be perseverations of consonants, such as mental capability instead of mental capacity. The second type are stranding errors, which lie in the principle that two words exchange their position, but their affixes stay on the original position. Examples may be my frozers are scholden instead of my shoulders are frozen, or a hole full of floors instead of a floor full of holes. Or another example may be a language needer learns instead of a language learner needs. Or there is a Czech example, sprchuju si studenou nohou vody instead of sprchuju si studenou vodou nohy, which may be roughly translated as I shower my waters with cold leg. From the point of view of spoken language production, the stranding errors are particularly interesting, because the fact that the affixes do not move together with the words may be interpreted as a sign that the grammatical structure is encoded first and the word forms are encoded only afterwards. The third type of errors are word exchanges. These are typical slips of the tongue, such as white Anglo-Saxon prostitute instead of white Anglo-Saxon Protestant, or funny slips by politicians, such as we will make breakfast a success instead of we will make Brexit a success, or abych tu pohanku dokouřil instead of abych tu pohádku dokončil, which may be translated as to finish smoking the buckwheat instead of to finish telling the fairy tale. As I already said, some logically possible speech errors do not occur. For example, a stranding error like my trousers are shoulden are quite frequent, whereas possible errors like shoulder mice froze arn just never happen. These types of errors are used as an evidence for the so-called two-stage models of grammatical encoding. These models distinguish between the functional processing and positional processing. During the functional processing, abstract lexical entries or lemmas are retrieved and assigned the grammatical functions. If this goes wrong, it results to word exchanges. During the positional processing, the serial order is imposed on the utterance and the grammatical functions generating during the functional processing are translated into linearized units. Also, the inflectional affixes are added here. If these processes go wrong, it leads to the stranding errors. The sound errors are then a product of problems with phonological encoding. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you would be interested in other models of language production than the classic model by Willem Lehfeldt, you should read the study Becoming Syntactic by Franklin Cheng, Gary Dell and Catherine Bock. In this study, the so-called dual path model of language production is introduced. If you enjoyed the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.